To everything, there is a season, a time to every purpose under heaven, a time to be born and a time to die. The Lord give and the Lord taketh away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. It is indeed an honor to stand before you and share our precious memories of Mommy. We will miss her dearly. She laughed with us at birthdays and weddings and cried with us through hardships and trials. She hurt when we hurt and rejoiced when we rejoiced. Maria Amalitha Glasgow was born on February 8, 1932 in Clifton, Union Island during the Great Depression era. She was the younger of two children born to her late mother, but one of several born to her late father. She attended the Ashton Government School in Union Island. Her ambition was to travel to the United Kingdom to become a nurse, but due to financial restraint, she was forced to stay on Union Island to attend sewing classes to become a seamstress. She met and married the late police officer Hawkins Glasgow, who was stationed in Union Island at the time. After their marriage, they migrated to the mainland of St. Vincent. Three children were born of their marriage, whom they lovingly called Vernie, Chris, and Frankie. My father's job gave my parents the opportunity to make their home in Gome, Sandy Bay, and Kittels. In 1965, they built their marital home in Kingston Park, where Mommy lived until she was called to her heavenly home on May 24th. Our mother was vibrant, warm, compassionate, and full of life. She was sophisticated in her dress and always looked her best when she left the house. She always lit up the room with her beautiful smile. She took pleasure in helping people. She was a good listener and always had an encouraging word. She would say, "God is good all the time." Family was very important to Mommy. She loved her children and grandchildren and would do anything for them. If there was strife, she would take the role of peacemaker. She strove for unity amongst her family. Mommy was a popular lady. Everyone, especially in Kingston Park, knew Miss Glasgow, as she was lovingly called. Even if people didn't see her on the porch, they would call out her name as they passed down the road. She would get up early in the morning, open up the front door, open up her bedroom windows, turn on the radio, and sit on the porch with a cup of tea, fried plantain, and toast, and read her Bible and pray. She was a prayer warrior. She was always praying us through our good times and our bad times. As a child growing up, I remember Mommy would always cook more than enough for her family. She always cooked enough so that she can give any neighbors and their children who came by the kitchen door. The neighbors knew that Miss Glasgow always had something to give them. When we were young, our father resigned from the police force and went to America to seek greener pastures. It was hard for my mother to raise three children by herself, but she did it without complaint. She worked extremely hard as a seamstress to support the three of us and to put us through secondary school. She was prone to getting terrible migraine headaches, but instead of lying down until the headache passed, she would band her forehead with a white handkerchief soaked in alkalado or limacol and kept on sewing in order to meet her deadlines. As a little girl, I would sit on the floor by her sewing machine watching and learning from her. She taught me to sew by giving me scraps of fabric and showed me how to cut and make dresses for my dolls. She was very patient and eager to show me everything she knew. She later graduated me to tying and cutting threads from garments. Then subsequently, I was helping her to hem dresses and finally, hand sewing decoration and gowns. Because of her love and passion for sewing, she became a renowned seamstress of Kingston Park, which afforded her the opportunity to turn out several bridal parties and the pleasure of outfitting many carnival queen contestants. She enjoyed traveling to the United States to shop and visit with her friends. She once took a healthcare attendant course in Virginia, where she learned the essential of checking blood pressure and blood sugar levels and to assist professionals to care for people with health problems. She graduated at the top of her class. During her last months here on earth, she was unable to read the Bible by herself because she said her eyes were dim. I would call her on the phone and pray with her and read the Bible to her. I could tell that she enjoyed our time of fellowship with the Lord. By the way, she said, amen, amen. I found pleasure in reading the Bible and praying with my mother. The day before she went home to be with the Lord, I was listening to a Bible program on the radio, and the preacher asked the listeners, if you knew you only had 6 months to live, what would you do? Of course, the first thought that came to my mind was that I would call my mother and pray with her and read the Bible to her. She passed away the next day. I flee closer to mommy when I read her Bible and see the many passages that she has highlighted with comments, such as, nice, I need this, or read this, or great chapter. Mommy established a relationship with Christ as her Lord and personal Savior in the late 1960s at the Streams of Power Church. But in the early 70s, she became a faithful and dedicated member of the Kingstown Church of Christ. She loved the Lord and lived her life to please Him. Coming to St. Vincent will never be the same for me. Who will spread the table with all kinds of food as if it were Thanksgiving Day? Before we came, she would ask us, what did we want to eat? She would prepare whatever we told her and then some. She prepared a spread for us from roti to kalaloo soup to breadfruit and saltfish. She baked bread and she baked cake. And then she would smilingly say, eat what you want. The table looked as if it were Thanksgiving Day. Mommy, thank you for everything you've done for us and given to us the love and the warmth we shared during your precious time here on earth. You will always be in our hearts. Thank you.